The spins might get a bit faster and maybe wetter, okay?
Yep.
There's towels down the middle if you need to use them, alright? Up the water underneath and it gets pushed out the back of the boat. Yeah, quite
How about one more 360 degree spin?
We're not over yet, we've got to see the falls.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah. We're just back at halfway. Come on, Mother. We're stopping for a tea or coffee. I probably wouldn't drink it, you'd go on the toilet later. But.
Have you been over to Rotorua yet?
Yeah.
Smelly town?
Yeah,
it's okay. Pass it again back there. So this is like the geothermal activity that they have over in Rotorua. We've got it here too. This is the geothermal power station. So that's what all the silver pipes are in the area running alongside the road. So there's steam, comes out of the ground, it's over 230 degrees Celsius and it travels over 200 kilometres an hour through those pipes. And here it's going through some turbines and they're generating electricity from it. Once they're done with it, it's water by the time they're finished with it. They either put it back into the river or they will re-inject it back into the ground so they can keep reusing the energy sources there. So they drill it back into the ground, or there's a little hot stream back there, which is why it's stinky. It's a sulphur. And the same in here. This is just the steam, the runoff from the power station, basically. So with the warm temperature of the water in here, the prawn farm just next door, have you been fishing?
Not yet.
No? Not yet? Inside the ponds, those prawns, they come from Malaysia and they need a lot warmer temperatures to grow in. And the prawn farm use this warm water in here and it goes through a heat exchange system, gets rid of any of the sulphur, and they use it and they pump it into the ponds. About 28 degrees Celsius what they need next door for the ponds. So they just use the free resources really. Good on them really, yeah. It'd be an expensive place to run without it. So this power station that's just behind us, that was the second geothermal power station to be built in the world, and it produces nearly 5% electricity for our country. So it's a great source of electricity really. It's also the tallest building in Taupo. 7 stories?
It's huge, it's like a skyscraper.
It's our skyscraper. Okay, we carry on, make our way up to the falls now. Just make sure you're looking good for the next few minutes. Alright, we're going to start recording a video.
Yep. Yeah,
okay. A camera at the front and a camera at the back. Don't worry about here, I've made it look nice for you.
Huh?
We made it! If you've got cameras in your pocket. We just let the river boat have his turn first, and he's going to come out, and then we're going to get up here a little bit closer.
Yeah. All right.
So actually, some people just behind us in here fishing. I think they're fishing. Have they got a rod?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there is a rod. There's a lot of trout in the river here. We have both brown and the rainbow trout. So catch your dinner if you want. Got to get a license to fish on them though.
Thank you.
At least the sun's out, you can dry off a little.